Hey there, welcome to Play Noggin. I'm Julian, your brain's player too. Everyone has done things they regret, whether it's ending a relationship, walking away from an opportunity, or ordering a Belgian waffle when you really wanted a bacon omelet. There isn't one person who doesn't have something they wish they could go back and change. Maybe because of this, time travel has been a staple of science fiction for generations. Today, we're looking at time travel game and teen angst simulator, Life is Strange. This is a game known for its story more than anything, and if you haven't played it, I'd hate to spoil that for you, but I'm going to have to for this video. If you have played, but it's been a while, let me take you back in time. Maxine Caulfield is a senior in high school in the seaside town of Arcadia Bay. One afternoon, she witnesses her former best friend, Chloe Price, murdered by a classmate. Suddenly, Max finds herself transported several minutes into the past. It seems that the universe has granted her the power to rewind time. Her first act is to save Chloe, but this sets her down a path towards disaster that unravels the world around her. So, the linchpin in the whole story is Max's ability to time travel. Scientists generally agree that time travel into the future is possible. In fact, you're doing it right now. Time is simply the rate of change in the universe, but time can advance at different rates for different objects due to a phenomenon called gravitational time dilation. Einstein laid it out in his theory of general relativity. Gravity is the result of mass distorting space, and space and time are actually linked. The closer in space you are to an object with a lot of mass, say a planet or an enormous star, the slower time moves for you. Jump into Earth's orbit and you're moving around 1/3 of a billionth of a second faster in time than us schlubs down here on Earth. But Max's power allows her to travel back in time too. That's a bit trickier, but necessary for the entire story to unfold. There have been a few proposed hypothetical mechanisms for backwards time travel. One is traveling faster than the speed of light. If somehow a pickup truck could travel to a distant town and back faster than light speed, then to an observer watching the truck from where it started, it would seem to leave and then reappear. The trip back would actually look like it was playing out in reverse, since the truck was ahead of the light it was emitting. To some observers, the truck would seem to arrive before it had even set off. Boom! Time travel achieved. This solution gels nicely with the rewind mechanic in Life is Strange, plus it deals with light and Max as a photographer, so that seems appropriate. What it doesn't gel nicely with is pretty much everything else, like the laws of physics. Even ignoring that Max very clearly isn't jumping to warp speed, there's the little niggle that nothing with mass can go light speed, let alone past it. Not Chloe's pickup, and not the most advanced spaceship we could ever build. The realization that light speed is a constant speed limit is what led Einstein to propose general relativity in the first place. It's just the law. But there may be a way to time travel by exploiting the laws of physics. The same rules of general relativity that bend space-time and cause time dilation could be used to create what's called a closed time-like curve. Kurt Gödel and Willem Jacob van Stockham proposed the existence of space-time that's been folded back in on itself to create a loop. Potentially, if Max could harness a closed time-like curve, time travel to the past might be possible. She would just need an insane gravitational force, like one provided by a spinning black hole. And as far as I know, one didn't just move in over Arcadia Bay. Unless you count the tornado that destroys the town at the end. You can't, but it's a nice idea. What the tornado actually represents in the game are the consequences of mucking around with causality. Causality is the relationship between causes and effects. Drop a bottle, it breaks. Fight a kid at school, get suspended, unless you're rich. You perform an action, and as a result, something happens. But while these small actions may have very obvious reactions, tiny changes can result in huge consequences for the bigger picture that are difficult to predict. The mathematical approach to understanding how little changes in a large system affect the outcome is called chaos theory, and the founding principle of chaos theory is what's known as the butterfly effect. The most well-known analogy is, if a butterfly flaps its wings in one place, it can cause a tornado somewhere else. This is a little misleading because it's not like the force of the breeze coming off its wings gains speed and somehow becomes a destructive whirlwind. What the analogy is saying is tiny changes can have huge and unpredictable consequences, and all Max is doing the entire game is making tiny changes. It starts with photographing a butterfly, and in the end, she causes the whole town's destruction with a tornado, unless she lets Chloe die. Hey, I said there'd be spoilers, but don't worry if you haven't played it, there's still lots to discover. Luckily for us, chaos doesn't mean just anything can happen. Max can't cause a solar eclipse or a second moon to appear. But there is one point when she goes back several years and saves Chloe's dad, and the end result is Chloe gets in an accident driving the truck her dad gave her for her birthday, and she's paralyzed. That's much more in the realm of probability. When the discoverer of the butterfly effect, Edward Lorenz, graphed the results of equations that describe the motion of gas, the outcomes weren't totally random. Instead, it looked like, hey, how about that? A butterfly. But if you do manage to screw everything up and set a tornado loose on your town, the laws of physics should keep you from going back in time and correcting your mistake, since you can't travel faster than light speed, and the odds of a surprise supermassive black hole are low. Plus, if you went back and stopped it from happening, then you'd never need to go back, giving rise to what's called the grandfather paradox. Some scientists have proposed that because of paradoxes like this, time travel must be impossible. But there are ways around the paradox, like the idea that your actions can cause the universe to branch into parallel universes when you change an event in the past. So if you regret the ending you picked for Max and Chloe, you can take some comfort in the thought that both endings could have happened. Or you could go back and play the game again. And this way, you can pick eggs and bacon instead of pancakes. Hey, we're out of time this week, but if you still want to know how parallel universes might be possible, check out our episode on BioShock Infinite here. Thanks for watching Play Noggin. As always, if you liked what you saw, please like and subscribe. Leave us a comment below with suggestions for which games you'd like to see us cover. And don't forget to keep on playing.